Hey guys, welcome to Clueless Insanity and welcome to the second episode in Simon Go Back series. Okay, the Simon did not go back in the first test. Hopefully it happens in the second test. Today, we have the 4 A's. Now that's a full attendance after a long time. And also there's a new guest. Welcome Vishal. And he's joining from, I mean, he's a Chennaite. Since we have the second test in Chennai as well, we thought we'll rope in and get few tips about the pitch as well. So, yes. Without further ado, we'll just go into the discussion. Since it's Vishal joining us, we'll ask him, Vishal, what went wrong? Why was the pitch so flat, like the road next to Marina Beach?
Well, I think benefit of the doubt should be given to the curator because it was his first pitch ever. But to be honest, the first 2 days was actually a road and there was no assistance for the bowlers, be it spinners or fast bowlers. And so there was no help at all. And I think England utilized the conditions well. And it was an important toss to win. And they got the runs on the board. And from then on, India were just in the back foot.
Right. We were just playing the chasing game after the first 2 days. Or maybe after the toss itself. The first session went well for us. They were 69 for two. We got two back-to-back wickets. And then we could not capitalize on it. Akshar, what about you? What went wrong? Is it the first innings batting of India or maybe second innings we could have batted better?
Yeah, I would still put it on our first innings batting effort. Honestly, whether the pitch is a road or whether it's a dynamite, I would expect this team to still beat England. And the factor was a lot of false shots, a lot of soft dismissals and Pujara's incredibly unlucky dismissal. Factors like these, I would say, made us go even further behind in our back foot. They put a good total. I expected us to do something that we have constantly done. Outperformed them in their first innings by scoring easily 100 or 200 more. I expected that, but that just didn't happen.
Yes, that was right. Ani, we watched the game closely. The number of no balls bowled in the game, that's, I guess we bowled 5 overs more than what was required. Our over rate, they should have considered better. They should not be collecting any points in the rankings. So, no ball, is it more to do with the body language? Rishabh Pant was constantly talking about it. What do you think body about become.
It? See, bowling no balls, one or two, it's fine. But spinners, especially bowling those big no balls, it's a crime. And Shahbaz Nadeem probably can rename himself as Shahbaz No Ball Nadeem. he was the one with a lot of them. But like even someone like Ashwin bowling a no ball, I don't understand. Like these people are international cricketers, and like the number of no balls, it's probably even due to the third umpire monitoring it. These no balls are getting recognized, maybe. So probably only they check it if there's a wicket or so. So that could be one reason. But we didn't see that happening from the England side. So the fault is on us. And I mean, these people are international cricketers. They have to rectify it. There's no excuse for it. And there's no Absolutely. Other reason which you can see for it as such.
Very true. Right. You mentioned a good point. Ashwin, for 70-odd test matches, he had not bowled a no-ball and he bowled two in this game. Amok, Akshar spoke about false shots. Which was the alarming shot or which batsman's wicket you feel was very crucial in the first innings?
If you see... In the context of the game, I would say Ajinkya Rahane's wicket was very, very crucial because just then the captain got out. It needed someone to calm the nerves, just keep things in motion. That was completely uncalled for. I feel, yeah, I understand he tried to put the pressure back on the bowler, but that shot playing in the air was a very big, in the context of the game, if you see that wicket made it really difficult for us. It came down to one big partnership, which, you know, saved us some grace. But otherwise, Ajinkya Rahane being the vice captain, he needs to show more maturity. I would say it was really his wicket that really changed.
Yes. In fact, that, you know, we lost momentum there, but thanks to Pant, it's like hit or miss. You can't always rely on someone like Pant.
Absolutely.
If he gets going, he goes. So it's a, you know, tough situation for us. But yeah, as you mentioned, Rahane's wicket at that point of time was very crucial. Akshar, what about the second innings bowling? Do you think we were playing the waiting game? There was some assistance for the spinners. The ball was gripping. But we did not see someone like Washington Sundar bowling itself. He bowled one over out of the 45 overs we bowled. So was it more to do with the England's declaration, or we were like, what do you think went wrong there?
In the second innings, I think we did a decent effort. We restricted them to 170. Although the damage mainly was done in the first innings, I think we attacked them in the right manner. Ashwin was brilliant with the ball. And I think the letdown in both innings for me was Shahbaz Nadeem. And in the second innings, he did bowl significantly better. But he was no threat like, say, Jack Leach was. And you saw in hardly a span of few more overs, Jack Leach was untouchable almost. And I would have hoped a seasoned veteran in these conditions, like Shahbaz Nadeem, who would do a lot more. That's about it.
That's a good point, which he's saying. Like, see, Jack Leach is foreign to this place, whereas Nadeem isn't. He has played enough number of domestic matches, which, you know, he should have exploited the conditions better, I feel, yes.
I'm sure there's a bit of nerves and other reasons, but I wouldn't pin it on one player, and I would also not say 174 was a bad performance. It was a first innings with the bat.
Yeah. There's an interesting number game here. The first innings, Dom Bess bowled 26 overs, picked 4 wickets, gave away 76 runs. And Jack Leach replicated the same. Like, he bowled 26 overs, gave away 76 runs and picked 4 wickets. Vishal, we were thinking about playing spin on the 5th day. Like, all the horrors or demons on the pitch was about spin. But then there's a legend who comes with his reverse swing and he was unplayable. That spell literally took the game away. What do you reckon from that?
Exactly. So I was watching the 5th day and I think we lost Pujara to Leach. And after that, Kohli and Shubman Gill were batting really well. And Shubman just reached his 50. And I was like, okay, come on, let's do a GABA. Let him keep scoring till lunch and let's take it from there. And then Anderson comes in, takes it, like reverse swings the ball, 2 wickets in 1 over. We cannot do much. Well, he's a legendary bowler. And the good thing was he was bowling to Pant. He got Pant out, but if he had bowled to Kohli, well, it would have been a great contest, but Anderson didn't bowl to Kohli in that spell. Not much. And he bowled to Pant. So he didn't reverse swing the ball that much because he was bowling to the left-hander. But he got Pant eventually. Anderson is just a legend. And you cannot do anything for that, for those 2 dismissals.
Yeah.
I think he would have got anyone out with those 2 balls.
Yes. Those were absolute rippers. Yeah. Amog, we'll talk about something positive from that game. Ishan Sharma picking up his 300th wicket. It's not easy for an Indian pacer who has played a lot of games in India to pick 300 wickets. So what do you reckon about him? He bowled really well, especially that one spell, which I feel Virat should have continued where he was struggling root.
Longevity in test cricket is, you know, the reason why, you know, players become from great to legends. And he's one of those players who, despite the number of injuries, you know, to keep bouncing back, to keep having that hunger within himself. It looks like it is some decades and decades ago where he bowled that amazing spell to Ricky Ponting. Yeah. But yeah, it's that hunger to like last for so long and to come back and keep doing the same thing. You know, those rewards are justified. 300 wickets, he deserved it.
Yes.
Ani, we picked Washington Sundar as a fifth bowler, but he was incredible with his bat. Okay, so what do you think? The next game, you'll be forced to take him because of his batting, or you'd want to drop him? Get if Akshar Patel is fit, you'd want to pick Akshar Patel in his place.
I see Washington Sundar as a part of the 11. So if there's any change, so that would happen with Shahbaz Nadeem. So like if Akshar Patel comes in there, or the talks of Kuldeep not having played a game. So there's a lot of social media outburst on it. So probably Kuldeep gets a game there. But as Virat said, then that would mean three bowlers doing kind of the same thing, but still they have variety. See, Washington bowls quicker through the air. Ashwin is quite slow on the track, and Kuldeep is a wrist spinner. So I see it that way. So Washington should still be in the team as a predominantly as a bowler, and not to be picked as a batsman. We should not let Washington Sundar be that main batsman. Our top order has to perform. So it is good that he's doing it, but let's not put more pressure on his batting.
Yes. I would like to add a point here, actually. I think, you know, as an Indian team, if you see, we always go with five bowling options, where one will be a fifth bowler who hardly gets to bowl. And the last time around, it was Jayant Yadav. I think in that entire series of 10 innings, I think he hardly got some 10 or 12 wickets. So I would say that's a role for Washington Sundar as well. Mm-hmm. To just hold one end up when you know, the other bowlers are getting tired. So I feel it is unfair that we're putting so much pressure on Washington. And he's done a phenomenal job on with the bat. And I would say we should just keep him. We should never change that, you know, department.
Don't think that's not broken. Yeah.
Okay, so we'll move on to the next game. Vishal, we hear that the track in Chennai might be a spinning one. It might spin from day one. That's what the new curator, Ramesh Kumar, spoke about. What do you think? Is it good that we go by rank turners, so that's what we are known for? Because we never get flat tracks when we go to England, right? So do you think that's a right move?
So coming to this pitch that's going to be used for the second test match. So basically in Chepauk, we have 8 surfaces that we can play on. And the surface that we played on in the first test match is a red soil based surface. So, but the other ones that are in place are more of the black soil or the clay type, even though the base is red soil. Mm-hmm. So I'm not exactly sure how they're going to prepare it. There were some reports that which said that they're going to keep it open and dry it as fast as possible in the heat, because you know Chennai, there's a lot of heat and it's always hot here. So if it is a rank turner and if it spins on day one, I think the toss will again play a huge role, because it deteriorates. The pitch will deteriorate as the game moves on. So again, the toss will be crucial, but I think there should be something for everyone on the pitch, at least on day one and day two. And as we move on to the third and fourth day, it should assist the spinners. because if it is a pitch that was similar to the first test match, then I think toss plays a huge role. So yeah, so I would like some assistance for the pacers, spinners, and decent bounce at least for the first 2 days so that the batsmen can play their shots.
Right. Yeah, talking of toss, Amok, since you're a huge Virat Kohli fan, would you advise some toss practice for him?
He can, I don't know who is the lucky charm in the Indian team. He should probably take that person along because he's definitely not having his vice captain as well, who's a lucky charm, because even Ajinkya Rahane kept losing the tosses. But see, at the end of the day, I would say if India had batted well and had they scored close to 500, it was a match on there. We still had a chance to, you know,
chase down as well.
At the end of fourth day, had they come in to bat, Ashwin would have run, they would have probably been bundled down less than 150 and we would have had a chance to chase it down. So right. I would say that if you just bat well, regardless whether we win the toss, let's say we are batting second, whatever they score, plus about few more should give us enough opportunity to win, which was the case in the last time around. And they have to just go back to what was their success formula.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's a very good point. Like maybe the openers, what we have seen, Rohit and Gill, either one will score the half century and they're not converting that. It would be good if both of them get those big daddy hundreds. And of course, we want Virat to score one century. It's been a long, long time, yeah. Right? And Akshar, what do you think about our batting? Do you think we will... I don't think there'll be any changes, but do you think we have to look it in a larger way, like four-match series, rest someone, just for a change? Do you think we will do that? I'm not sure. Indians are never, they never touch the batting order. It's mostly to do with the 5, 6, 7 and three bowlers are always set.
Yeah, the way I look at it, I think we have great bench strength, to be honest. But I still don't see this team changing. Probably never in all the four matches unless we are... going to the last match 2-1 up. The thing is that they're all class acts who have scored tons of runs in India. And all I see is that they have now learned what it takes for them to lose their wicket. It's just a bit of loss in concentration or bad luck. So they will now come back harder and they will ensure that they... get their money's worth for every wicket. And that's all I wish for them. I just want them to apply themselves and that's enough, honestly. We'll get there. We'll win this.
Yes, it is very important.
If I can add a point here to what Akshay said, I think we need Rahane to come back to form. Mm. We know that he scored a century in Melbourne. And after that, he's not been amongst the runs, scored 30-odd here and there. And if you see his record in India for the last 4 years, his average is, I think, if I'm not wrong, in the mid-30s, 36 or something like that. Okay. And he plays number 5. So I hope Rahane comes back to form and scores big in the next test match. Yeah,
I would like to add a point as well to what Akshay said. And it's very important. And it's been some time since we've seen a Big Daddy 100. I'm not able to recollect the last time we did it as well. So it's about time, you know, someone's due here. Who better than, one of the veterans like Rohit Sharma or Virat Kohli? If one of them gone to bat and score those big hundreds, I think that will set the game.
Yes, for sure. And it's very important to win the next game because if we are talking of the World Test Championship, the next game is very crucial and we have to win. But here's some good news, which might not be good news also for Indian fans. there are talks that Anderson might miss the next game, and also Jofra Archer. But I mean, if you see the replacements, it's not good news again. It's Chris Woakes and Stuart Broad. So, Ani, what do you reckon about that? Do you think the Indian players will be thinking on this aspect, or they'll just concentrate what's there on the game?
See, Abhi, after the first game, I'm pretty sure there's a lot of talks which has gone around, and Indians would not see who's the bowler. I mean, they would be prepared enough to face whoever it is. Like, yes, if Anderson is not playing, that kind of gives a positive tone for the Indians. So whomsoever plays, like Broad plays, or if Jofra Archer, I heard he has some sickness, I think he'll play the next game. If at all he doesn't play, then it's kind of a bit added advantage that two new bowlers are there, like they are playing their first game now in the series. But even otherwise, I am quite a bit sure that we'll bat much, much better than the first game, irrespective of whoever the bowler is.
Yes, Virat would be straightforward in telling whatever happens, let's concentrate on our game and our game plan and forget about the opposite team. Yes, so this is a quick fire. We are moving into the last segment. Vishal, if there's any change, you'll have to name one.
Probably Akshar Patel, instead of Shahbaz Nadeem.
Yeah. Okay. Akshar, if Akshar Patel is not fit, then who?
Then it's Kuldeep. I see Kuldeep instead of Shahbaz Nadeem, and we go for it. Yeah.
Ani?
Kuldeep in place of Shahbaz Nadeem. Although I would want someone like Mayank, who has like a Bradman average in India, but I don't want to make any changes in the batting now.
Amog, now you will have to wrap it. You should. This is a quick fire one.
Yeah, mute, Amog.
I think everyone's pointed out there's only one change, Nadeem. He didn't even hold his bat well. So, just Kuldeep will do better, at least in that segment, if not contain runs.
Okay. In fact, I remember me and Amog having a conversation about not having Nadeem in the squad before the test series, and after the first test match.
I know. Now we know why he's not included. So, yeah.
Yes. Well, it was a great discussion. Hope we win the second test and we level the series, and then the third test, the pink ball test, and also in the new stadium will be more exciting. We'll have the discussion before that test as well. Thank you guys for joining, and thank you for sharing your valuable inputs. And dear viewers, thank you for watching this video. Do like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And also, don't forget to watch our rest of the videos in the Let Go Back Simon series. Thank you. Cheers.
Go back, Simon.